Today you pull a helmet back on once again. And he's had a blast around here in a Shell V Power Racing Team Mustang. Let's have a look at it.
Not doing much of a job talking here. I'm just too busy, having way too much fun. Not ready to come to the start finish line here. One more fast lap. Trying to slow the car down. Pump. Down to second gear. Watch this curve on the left-hand side. It's treacherous. Hit the power on as hard as you can. Drives are busy down here. Changing gears, changing brake bars. I'm looking for the 150. Can't get there. Nice high and wide, get good momentum off this. Really tight, one of the tightest in the country. Now stretch the engine's legs, getting up to sixth gear around the kink. Now I'm thinking about a brake zone, brake in the middle of the track. Trying to get up here into turn six, not easy to do. Carry some momentum in across the middle, feed the power on.
And what did you think?
Will was looking quite nervous, wasn't he?
Yeah, what? That was the pretend smile of, oh, it's really cool. Marcus is in my car.
Yeah,
I'm loving this.
Yeah. I'm really not loving it. I'm trying to smile at the same time. What a thrill. It's been a long time since I've actually sat back in a race car. Last time in earnest was Bathurst 1000 in that car back in 2015, I think. So it's been a long time between drinks. A lot of power, a lot of grip, a lot of side bite, but what really impressed me was just the car was moving like an old supercar was. It was just, you know, pitching under brakes nicely, a lot of lateral movement. You can actually see that in the cars around here. Yeah. They are moving a lot around the racetrack.
Scafie's a competitive dog. He thinks he's at the diving. He started to write the number 3 on the back of a bit of paper here. He was going to hold it up like the diving to give you a score out of 10. He was a pretty harsh marker.
Oh, a 3, you reckon?
I wasn't. Yeah, you just dipped me in. I did not say that at all. Hey, what I wanted to do is just give everyone a real quick wrap, because this come from your chat with Ambrose, with Marcus yesterday, the way that you've then applied yourself. Nathan Prendergast got this sorted. Ryan Story got you a licence. Motorsport Australia gave the licence. Got the whole thing done. It's great when this industry gets stuff done. And this morning, to have a big smile on your face, mate, and jump in one of these cars around here at your home racetrack was fantastic.
So it was bloody, better than a cup
well
of coffee,
done.
I'll put it that way, right?
Yeah, well done.
Yeah, no, a lot of fun. And a big thank you to everybody too, Ryan Story, and everyone at DJR for putting that deal together.
Yeah.
I couldn't even find a helmet last night. I had to go through my storage and try and find a helmet. And what a great blast, and for Will for donating his car as well. Yeah, I was very careful with the car. I just didn't want to do the wrong thing by him. They've got two big races today. He's running fast. I brought it back in one piece.
Perfect.
Had fun. It was a great day.
Yeah, well done.
Problem is the bug never goes away.
No, that's the worst part.
And
it
already he told me yesterday that his girls are actually racing. I said, you should know better than that by now. So you're back in a race car. Really good to see you. Great to have you on the desk with us this weekend and contributing to our broadcast, Marcus. And it's a really great local and international racing story, Marcus Ambrose, and what he's done in his career. So fabulous to see him in the Shell V-Power car earlier in the day.